6 of lockdown. Today we've got an intermediate class for you that is a bit of a class that, in a way, we've danced it, but we've never taught it. So it's one of those things that we just go into sometimes when we're dancing, but we've never taught it. So we thought we'll bring it to you guys today so you can do it as well. Don't forget health and safety. Make sure that the room's nice and clear so you can dance. You've got drinks that you can rehydrate with. And if you're not feeling too well, see a doctor because it is a form of sport and exercise. So don't go damaging yourself. So guys, we're going to start off with class 36, and it's going to look a little bit like this. Okay guys, so as we start, we're going to do a left to right hand hold grip. And as we break, we're going to offer the right hand. Now for foot patterns and things like that, just have a look below and you'll see all our other classes that we've done with foot patterns and things like that. If you can get a foot pattern on a 4-4 count, which is what Modern Jive is, it will make your life much easier when you're doing intermediate classes. So that's why we sort of try to look towards that. Now, from there, as we offer this hand, I'm going to bring the lady in. I'm going to bring this right hand over and over the lady's arm, okay? Now, if you can see that from the camera, the elbow is pointing down, and we've done this actual one on another class below, and the fingers are just gripping my palm up, lady's fingers pointing down, and we just go over that elbow. What happens is we don't, as we see from there, we go over the elbow. I can almost let go if I have to, and the lady's hand will just drop onto the shoulder. But if we can just keep hold fingertip grip, that's good enough for me, that's all we need. The left hand is the same, but what you don't want to do is grip, because if you grip, you won't get the arm over there properly, because you've taken up, if you imagine, as a fingertip grip, we've got this amount of distance from there to there. But as soon as we get a grip, we've only got this amount of distance from there to there. So it means that getting this elbow not only is uncomfortable, but it's far longer now going below the lady's arm. If we fingertip grip, we go straight above the arm. Okay? So what it means is we don't have to bring this elbow out. Because we want to make sure the lady's nose is okay. Because we liked it at the beginning of the dance, we want to like it at the end. Now we're going to do it with the left hand as well, and the left hand is exactly the same. It's fingertip to fingertip, over and there, okay? And that's all we do. But we're going to do a slight twist. So before we do it together, gents, imagine that what you're doing is you're using your chest, and as you get over, you're going to direct the lady one way, you're going to direct the lady the other way. So as I'm directly at the camera now, I'm going to go to quarter turns to the edge of the room. So I'm just going to look to the left and look to the right, and that's all I'm going to be doing. So I'm using the chest, not the arms. I'm not steering with the arms, I'm just doing that. Now ladies, what you need to do is relax those arms, and because it's quite a close hold, you will just go directly with the man. So there you're going to go to the man's right, there you're going to go to the man's left, okay? And it's because I've just used my shoulders. Okay, so if we do it from this side for you, so we're going to break on one, to the right on two, to the left on three, and then as we get back, I'm going to turn the lady back, and I'm going to give her a little bit of extra where I'm almost walking towards her. So if you stay there, so what's going to happen is as I turn, I'm almost going that way, and that puts the lady back on the right foot. Okay, okay, so we're going to break on one and offer, in on two, round on three, back on four, back on five, and that's all chest movement. Now here, I've relaxed back, so the lady's back on her right foot. Now I'm going to not turn this time, I'm going to bring her forward on her left. Then I'm going to turn, and I'm going to take her back on her right. I'm going to turn on the left, on the right. So she's doing nice little ochos. Now ladies, as you do the ocho, what you want to do is bring your feet together on the twist and step. Feet together, twist and step. One and two, three and four. Okay, and as you can see from here, guys, these are here. It's quite a tight, close little move, but because the lady's on a twist and I'm keeping my body in that side, I'm just bringing her forward. Now, if I turn my body, she can't go forward, she can't do the ocho, she falls backwards and sideways. So make sure that you get the turn for the ocho and then you're straight for the step across. Turn for the ocho, straight for the step across. Turn, straight, turn, straight. Legs together, ladies. Legs together. Inside leg, leg closest to the man. Leg closest, left leg, right leg. Okay, and that's basically the first part of the move. So it's doing little ochos, which is, we've done them before, but never like that. Okay, so the next part of the move, we'll do this again from this side for you, we've not done it from this angle. Break one, in two, over three, over four, five, with a step, in, and turn, in, and turn. And on this one now, she's on the left-hand side, and watch my left foot for the leads. I'm going to walk around me my left as the lady pivots on her left. And then we come out on the other side, as she steps on the right, onto the left, and she's out. Okay. So the lady comes into the left, one, across two, and it's when she's on our left side, my left leg goes around, then my right, step, step, and finish. Okay, so, anything to ask for the girls?
No, it's easier if you slide your foot along the floor, and then when you bring your feet together, the weight changes so that the weight's on your outside leg, and then the weight's free to go on the inside leg to slide, so you keep exchanging the weight. Slide, switch, slide, switch.
Yeah, so as Jane says, a lot of times with things like this, once we then transfer the weight onto the travelling foot, if we're not careful, we then wobble a bit and change feet. And what we don't want to do is change feet. We want to keep the weight on this left all the way around. Okay. And although Jane slid her foot, which is correct, I'm keeping mine in the air so you can see, and then the right foot goes across. And then all the weight is on the right foot, none is on the left, and then the left foot goes across. So hopefully you can see that. That's just visually so you can see it. It's much nicer and much easier if the lady slides that foot across. So as that left foot has got the weight, the right foot slides, the right foot stays up, the right foot goes across, we slide with the left foot goes across, we slide with the right. So we're alternating right foot, left foot, right foot, left foot. And obviously that will only go as much as the man turns you. And while he's using his shoulders, that is your indication. So he turns you one way, then he leads you across. He turns you the other way, he leads you across. Okay, so let's just put all that together for you, and then we'll put an ending on. So break on one, in on two, round on three, across on four, round on five and back to six. We step in seven and eight, one and two, three, and four. We can do this as long as you want, but as we get the lady to the left here, as the lady, my shoulders turn the lady, that's when I'm going to step round. So as I turn, I step round, round, step, step, out. Okay, so a little bit of speed on that. We'll do it from this side because we've never done it from this side. So we're going to go one and two, three and four, five and six, seven and eight, one and two, ready to spin, round and step, finish. Okay, and then from here, guys, all we're going to do is we're going to break, I'm going to bring the lady in, into hold, and we're back into a nice little close hold together. So from this direction, we're going to go one and two, three and four, five, out six, in seven, turn eight, one and two, three, and turn, step and pivot, out. Over the lady's head, outside turn, take the hand and just back into a close little hold. Okay, so the very last part of that, just so you can see it from this side, guys, is once we've actually brought this move, and all we've done is we've released this from here and gone out, I'm going to step around the lady on the outside, and the lady is going to turn to her left, so she's going anti-clockwise under the arm. I let go with the right, but I go round the shoulder, down the shoulder, down the shoulder blade, and hold. And then from here, we just into a little close hold. Lower the left, relax, and take your time. Gary's going to do that to music for you. We hope you've enjoyed. That's class number 36, and we're back with another class for you next week, which I think will keep us a surprise. I've got ideas, Okay, guys, thank you very much. Stay safe, and we'll see you soon. Right. Guys, don't forget, if you're liking the classes, please subscribe if you haven't already done so, just down below. And just strike that little bell as well, because then we'll send everything out to you as we bring new things up. And basically, the more you like, the more you share, the more YouTube likes, and the more YouTube shares, and the more dancers we get. So hopefully when we get back into our venues, we'll have millions of new dancers. Guys, thank you very much. If you like our videos, click the like button, the little thumbs up. If you want to see more of our videos and be part of our little group, press subscribe. And if you'd like to be notified of any new videos coming out, then press the bell as well.